Hey guys, this week's video is all about thrush and more specifically vaginal thrush. So we're going to talk about the symptoms, the causes, we're going to talk about lifestyle advice on preventing it and treating it, as well as the treatment options that are available as well. This video is going to be jam-packed full of information. So as I mentioned, this video is going to have loads of information, so it's probably going to be quite long. So if at any point you want to find any specific information, the good news is the entire video is chaptered. If you click on the description below, you'll see the different chapters of information. Feel free to click on it and watch that section. However, I would always recommend that you watch the entire video and become a bit of a pro on the topic. So let's begin with what is vaginal thrush. The best way to understand this to begin with is we have germs all over our body and inside our body. We have germs that are friendly, for example in our stomach, we have friendly bacteria which aids the digestion of certain types of foods, and also we have different types of germs that when they're at a normal level, they're harmless, but if they multiply rapidly and grow, they can cause us some harm and symptoms. Now, one of these germs which is specific to vaginal thrush is a fungus, and it's a family known as Candida. Candida loves warm, moist, and airless environments, and the vagina is a great place for this. Now, Candida is found on the skin and in the vaginal region as well. When it's at normal levels, it's harmless. But again, like I said, when it multiplies and grows rapidly, that's when it can start to cause us some symptoms and problems. So vaginal thrush is known as a common yeast infection. Most women will have it at some point in their lifetime, and it can be unpleasant and uncomfortable. But the good news is that it can be treated by speaking to your pharmacist or your other healthcare professionals that are available. Now, in most cases, you don't usually need a test to diagnose vaginal thrush. Certain times, if someone's getting recurrent vaginal thrush, for example, it might be done, but in usual cases, just from symptoms alone, a diagnosis can be made. Now, it's important to remember, please, just from the symptoms that I'm going to discuss now, you shouldn't be making a diagnosis of vaginal thrush. You should be speaking to a healthcare professional to make this so they can ask you the right questions, so they can possibly examine you if it's needed, just so they can make the diagnosis. We shouldn't be making these diagnoses on our own. That's why it's important that you speak to a healthcare professional. The common symptoms of vaginal thrush, I'm gonna have a little box appear here. Feel free to press pause on the video, give it a read, check if any of them apply to you, and if they do, you do need to speak to your healthcare professional. That's really important that you do so. Okay, so now, firstly, to begin with, we're gonna talk about preventative and lifestyle measures that can help with thrush. I'm gonna do it in this order first, because I feel like most people will probably gain more benefit from learning of these first, because these are things that you can do at home, and then afterwards we're going to talk about treatment that you need to speak to your pharmacist or healthcare professional about, which are usually prescription treatments, so we're going to talk about them next. So for tip number one, when showering, use water and an emollient soap substitute to clean the skin around your vagina and that region, but avoid cleaning this area more than once a day. You don't want to be overwashing. Moving on to tip number two, it's also important to protect that region. It's a very delicate region, and applying a thicker, greasier moisturizer on that region several times a day can also really help. Tip number three is all about avoiding irritants, because certain soaps, for example, the perfumed ones, they can cause irritation, certain wipes can, certain vaginal deodorants can, so all of these can potentially cause irritation in the region and also then cause thrush as a result of it. Certain shower gels as well to be aware of can cause irritation. Usually all the perfumed ones cause irritation. Tip number four is all about wearing looser fitting clothing. If you're wearing really tight clothes, this can sometimes make thrush worse or make the symptoms worse or even exacerbate symptoms or even give you thrush potentially due to all the chafing and movement in that region. Remember, it's all about loose fitting clothing, loose fitting underwear. This is all really going to help. Moving on to tip number five, you need to avoid using biological washing powders and fabric softeners. Again, these are all irritants also. Moving on to tip number six, probiotics. Unfortunately, there's no real evidence supporting probiotics for preventing thrush, so please don't waste your money on them. Tip number seven, please remember that thrush is not a sexually transmitted infection. However, if you are having a lot of sex, friction can increase your risk of getting thrush. So please remember this, that if your natural secretions are not enough and it's not lubricated enough, then look at buying some lubricants that could help with this and reduce the friction. But also please remember, after having sex, make sure to wipe and dry the area also. This is really important for preventing thrush. Tip number eight, certain medicines can actually increase your risk of getting thrush. For example, probably the most common one is antibiotics. Antibiotics obviously kill the bacteria, they don't kill fungus, and certain bacteria in that region do stop the fungus from rapidly increasing. So if we had antibiotics and it's got rid of that good bacteria that's preventing the fungus from increasing, it can suddenly multiply and cause thrush. So if you are someone who takes, whenever you take antibiotics, for example, you get vaginal thrush, speak to your healthcare professional about it, let them know when they're prescribing it. They may prescribe you some other medication as well to take in case you are gonna get vaginal thrush. And tip number 9, there are certain other medicines that can increase your risk of vaginal thrush as well. So if you are taking quite a few medicines, this is a great opportunity to maybe speak to your pharmacist or your other healthcare professionals to get their advice on it as well and see what they think. Please do not stop any medicines that you're taking, that you've been prescribed. Always first speak to your healthcare professional. Okay, so I hope we're getting somewhere now. We know all about the tips, the lifestyle stuff that we can do, but the next thing I want to discuss to you are the treatment options. And there are many different treatment options that you can purchase right at a pharmacy or a chemist here in the UK. So let's talk about how it works. So first of all, I'm aware that obviously vaginal thrush, the conversation of thrush can be a little embarrassing at times, especially in a chemist when there's other people there. So if you ever want to have a private consultation or a conversation with the pharmacist, just ask them if you can speak to them privately in the consulting room. Every chemist here in the UK has a private consulting room where it will just be you and the pharmacist. So you don't need to worry about other people hearing it. There's doors in it, it's closed, it's all private, so no one else can hear it. So I really want you to remember that because I don't think a lot of patients are aware of this, so it's good for you to know that. Okay, so when it comes to treating thrush, we need to treat it with antifungal medication, and it usually comes in 4 different forms when we're looking at treating vaginal thrush. So first of all, one form is a pessary, for example. It's like a bullet-shaped tablet and it's inserted into the vagina. Another form is what we call intravaginal creams. Again, it usually comes with an applicator, it's inserted to the vagina and the cream is squeezed in. It also comes in a tablet form that you can take orally, and it also comes as a normal cream that you can apply around the area. So here's the important bit. This is one of the main reasons why you need to speak to a healthcare professional first. Obviously, they need to make sure that you're safe and suitable to use that medication because these medicines interact with loads of medicines, first of all. And also, they need to make sure that you're safe and suitable to use it. So that's one of the reasons why you need to speak to a healthcare professional. But also, they need to understand your symptoms, whether you're having internal symptoms, external symptoms. So for example, do they need to treat the thrush internally? So do they need to use a pessary or the intravaginal cream or a capsule, a tablet? Or is it just external symptoms of itching, for example, where a cream can just be used? Or is it both, where they need to use both? So these are one of the main reasons why you need to speak to a healthcare professional so they can give you the correct treatment to give you the best outcomes, really. They also need to check how often you're having thrush because this is a really important question and it might mean that you might need further investigations or you need to speak to your doctor or other healthcare professional. So as we mentioned, vaginal thrush is very common in women. Most women will have it at some point in their lifetime. As we mentioned earlier, that yeast, Candida, is all over the body on the skin, and it's usually something that causes it to multiply and then cause vaginal thrush. Now, certain people are at a much higher risk of getting vaginal thrush, and it's quite a big list. I'm gonna try and fit it all here for you, the information. So at this point in the video, feel free to pause it, give it a read, and see if any of them apply to you. Now, if you've had thrush before and you think you've had it again, you can obviously purchase over-the-counter medicines to treat it. Again, always do get your healthcare professional involved in it. This is really important, just so they can question and ask how often you're getting it, whether there's something underlying that's potentially causing it. Now, there are also other reasons why you should speak to a healthcare professional. So it's, again, quite a big list. I'm gonna leave it here, a big list of it. Have a read through it. These are all the different reasons why you should seek medical attention for vaginal thrush. If any of these apply to you, please do speak to a healthcare professional. Don't just go out there and buy these treatments and keep masking these symptoms when they keep coming back, for example. So there's loads of different reasons why you should speak to a healthcare professional. These are really the main list on when to seek medical attention. So that's the end of this week's video. I hope you found this information helpful. We now know all about vaginal thrush, why it happens. We know about Candida. We now know all about preventative and lifestyle tips that can help prevent thrush and can also help with symptoms slightly as well. And we know about the treatment options that are available and the importance of seeking medical attention. So you're a bit of a pro when it comes to vaginal thrush. I really hope that you found this information helpful. Please do leave some comments below. I'd love to read, I'm sure people watching this video would too, on anything that you find to be quite helpful as well. And as I always say at the end of every single week's video, always remember that you're awesome and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.